In today's class, we are going to talk about the duties or obligation of banks. Now, as you can see on my screen, there are basically five obligations of bankers. Obligations to honor checks, obligation to maintain secrecy, obligation to follow customers' instructions, obligation to maintain proper records, and obligation to give notice before closing the account. Now, one might wonder, what is the difference between right and obligation? See, when we talk about right of banks, then it is something that they are entitled to do. It is their own right, it is their own, ek tarah se hum keh sakte hain ki wo unka haq hai. When they charge interest, then it is their right to do so. When they charge for services that they offer, then it is their right to do so. When they are able to close the account of the customer, then it is their right to do so. They are entitled to do so by the RBI. But when we talk about obligation of banks, then obligations are or duties of banks are those which the banker must do. It is liable to do it. It is not its right to do it. So when we talk about obligations, then obligations are something that bankers try to maintain. They try for their relationship between the customer and the banker, or for maintaining the relationship between the customer and the banker. It is very obvious that banks are obligated to do a few things. They do not have the right, but they are obligated to do these following things. So let us see the first one, that is obligation to honor checks. Now, when banks are presented with checks from the by the customer, then they are obligated, they are statutory obligated to honor these checks, provided that there is enough credit in the customer's account. For example, if my particular account is in Canara Bank and I say there are 10,000 rupees in my bank, and if I present a check that is worth 8,000 rupees, then it is the obligation of the banker to honor the check that I have given to the bank, because I have enough amount or enough balance in my particular account. If the check would have been of 15,000 rupees or 20,000 rupees, then it is not obligatory on the banks to honor the check. But in case the credit is there, then the banks are obligated to honor the check. If a bank wrongfully refuses to honor the check to its customer, then the customer is liable and the customer has the option of suing the bank or withdrawing his account from the bank. Or he may demand a compensation from the bank, saying that why did you refuse to honor my check. For example, if I have written a check to a particular car financing company and that check has bounced despite the fact that there was enough balance in my particular account and the check has bounced for no apparent reason, then I am in a position to question the bank. So it is the bank's obligation to honor all the checks that I present to the bank, provided that there is enough amount in my particular account. There are other reasons also. Why this particular check needs to be honored, or in under what circumstances that these checks need to be honored. Of course, the first one we've discussed, that there must be sufficient fund of the customer in the customer's account. Then the second is that the funds must be properly applicable for the payment of the customer's check, which means that these funds should be available to the bank to make requisite payments. These funds should not be tied up in other forms of bank instruments. They must be lying idle in the customer's account to make that particular payment. Then the check must be properly drawn up. What does this mean? The check must be properly drawn up, which means that the name of the customer should be correct. The name of the person to whom this check is being given should be properly mentioned. The date should be properly mentioned. The sign of the customer should be properly done. It should match the bank's records. the check should not be torn, it should not be mutilated. So given all these conditions, it is important that, or it is in fact obligatory to the bank to honor the checks that are being presented to them by the customers, provided that there are sufficient funds, provided that it is properly applicable, provided that it is properly drawn up, it is not torn, it is not mutilated, the signatures are not forged, the name of the customer is correct, the account number is correct, etc., etc. Now, the situations on how the check needs to be endorsed, how it needs to be presented, when the check gets refused or bounced, all this we will be doing in very, very great details in the second unit of our syllabus. So, moving on to the of course, there are other conditions as well, that it must be presented within reasonable time. And another very important element is that, provided that there are no legal bars on the customer to make the payment. For example, in certain situations, the court, the High Court or the Supreme Court of the country may prohibit a customer to pay the payments till its earlier dues are cleared, till his earlier dues are cleared. So in that case, he might put a bar on the transactions of the customers. So aisi bhi koi situation nahi honi chahiye jisse ki bank apne aapko majboor paaye ya unable paaye apna check honor karne ke liye. So these conditions need to be kept in mind, but at the same time, and if these conditions are not there, then it is obligatory to the banks to honor the checks that are presented by the customer. So this is the first duty or first obligation of the banker, that is to the obligation to honor checks. Now let us do the second, that is obligation to maintain secrecy. Now the transactions that take place between the customer and the banker should be kept extremely secretive, should be kept extremely private. They should not be shared with any other XYZ agency by the bank, because maintaining customer secrecy is also an obligation or a duty of the banker. So the bank must not disclose to any outsider the details concerning the customer's account, and he should make sure that these disclosures are extremely private in nature, because they may sometimes affect the credit and business of the customer. So the banker should never ever divulge the detail of the customer's account to other parties. However, in certain circumstances, the bank may be required to disclose the transactions to a third party. Now, what are those situations? When the law requires such disclosures, or when the practices among other banks permit such disclosure. Now, I will give you a very recent example. All of you are following the Sushant Singh Rajput and Riya Chakravarti controversy.
Yes, ma'am.
What is happening in that? The Enforcement Directorate is going to different banks in which Sushant Singh Rajput had his accounts and checking how the funds have been transferred from one bank to the other, or from one account to the other. Normally,
yes,
in due course, this would never happen, as in the banks would never inform the authorities about where the money is being transferred. But because this case is now open for investigation, therefore the Enforcement Directorate or the CBI is now going and asking all the banks about the transactions. And in such cases, because the law requires such disclosures to take place, that is why the banks are also giving up all the information that is associated with the account. So is it very clear?
Yes, ma'am.
You have understood this, what this means? That normally banks are supposed to maintain secrecy, but if the law permits, or in cases when other banks are demanding information, like for example, I am a very, very big businessman and I am planning to take a very huge loan. So in that case, I approach a particular bank to give me that particular loan. But I want to ask other banks in which the customer has an account that what exactly is his credit worthiness, how is his behavior, how has he been giving the interest payments, etc. So in that case, I might ask other banks to give me a brief information about the businessman. So that in that case also, banks are, they can divulge the information related to a customer account. But under normal circumstances, banks should never divulge the information of a customer's account.